So it's Sunday night and we're gonna get stuff done. And we were talking about some things. Some things came up in some of the forums this week about touch IC jobs. And you know, Mark has done a ton of touch IC jobs, but lately I've been doing touch IC jobs as well. So I think it's time for a touch IC showdown. I fully expect to lose, but what we've both noticed is that there's some common faults after your touch IC repair. So when you're replacing Cumulus and Mason in iPhone 6 Plus especially, there are a set of sort of common complications that really are heat transfer through the board. One is grayed out Wi-Fi. So if you have too much heat on the Wi-Fi chip area, that can damage that chip. Another one is a problem with the proximity sensor where it's not working anymore. Another one is a problem with the ambient light sensor. Another one is a problem with the cameras, the front or rear camera. So you want to check cameras, Wi-Fi, proximity sensor, ambient light sensor, and also backlight, which is pretty obvious. All of those can be a symptom of too much heat in your touch IC repair. Am I missing any of those?
Nope, I think you got it all.
All right, so our prediction is that if the two of us sit here and if we both take two touch IC jobs sort of out of the stack and we both do them, that we'll probably run into these common complications so we can sort of walk you through what to look for and how to fix that. So that's our plan. So we're gonna go ahead and do our touch IC showdown. We're each gonna do two, so that's a set of four, and we'll see what kind of problems we run into. I think it would be amazing, and the first ever, if all four of them went flawless. What's the chance of that happening? None?
Zero.
Zero. All right, so here's the box of incoming from today, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, take two. Two hard ones. Are you getting the bottom one? You think I stuck an easy one on the bottom?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. I will pick this one. Do you think that do you have like a black phone, white phone favorite?
No, but I took one of each.
Me too. I got a black phone. And white phone. I don't want to.
No, these aren't like Christie's iPad minis.
Yes, Christie believes that the white iPad mini is the devil. All right, so step one with all touch IC jobs is to take the board out. Now, when you do touch, do you like confirm stuff at the beginning or what?
I will usually confirm that it powers on.
Yeah, my note says iPhone 6 Plus touch IC issue.
Or at least shows a display.
Yeah, mine has classic touch. I just saw a flicker.
Mine is not charged.
Wow. All right, let's check. Great, other one. It's okay. So,
no problem.
So invoice and just needed the master's touch, wave of the hand.
Yeah.
So what do you do in that situation when it shows up to you with no defect?
Give it a little bit of a flex, and it will usually.
Oh, gray bars.
Yeah. Yeah, I just. Yep, gray bars.
Yeah.
And now
so
no touch.
Mine too. Oh my God, it's like totally the same. But on mine, I am going to pre-check my cameras to make sure I don't have a parts problem. Now I wish I hadn't touched it.
Yeah,
I want my touch back. Woo! What was the last video? Did you even watch the one that we did the last time you were here?
No.
No?
No, the last video I watched was the Sharky one, and it was only because the title, I was like, what? Why would there be a video with that title?
Did you see, I think it's pretty obvious that, do you think it's pretty obvious that not all of the iPad rehab comments are actually authored by Jessa?
It's obvious to somebody who knows Jessa. But I don't think it's obvious to the general public.
Right,
but now it is.
Well, I think it's appropriate after a while. You know, you want to keep up with YouTube, and it's just so many questions and stuff. You can't. So I think it's appropriate to, and YouTube allows you to kind of like appoint like a manager.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's appropriate.
Yeah.
The manager I chose is kind of a douchebag, though. He kind of hates me.
Yeah, but he's nice to your users.
Yeah.
He's nice to your viewers.
Like, really nice. Like, surprisingly nice. Except for every now and then, where he, like, said on one guy said, I don't know, some comment, and then he was, it's some, like, inappropriate comment. He was like, oh, thank you. I wouldn't have said that. No, he said, thank you. And then he goes, ASL, which I had to look up means.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's from like, 1994.
Yeah, right.
Message boards.
Right, janky ass.
Yeah, we put it under the microscope and shoved extra pins in the digitizer connector.
Just to fuck with him. Ha ha ha! That would be actually, like, not that janky at all. That would be kind of high tech. That would be, like, high tech sabotage. For what gain? You know, like, why would we do that?
So the debate is, I believe it said shred shop.
I think if it did say shred shop, which I don't think it did.
It did.
That he meant... I think he just meant janky ass shop.
Are you still
shop.
Checking that board out?
Yeah. Since I've been, I don't do general repair. I'm a specialist. I do board repair. So this is really outside of my.
You're a diva.
My comfort zone. Yeah.
I'm gonna take the sticker off.
You're gonna take the sticker off. Wait, yeah. I take the sticker off. You can't steal my technique. You don't even watch my channel.
All right,
that's
I'm putting
BS.
The sticker back on. Battery symbol.
All right, let's look at my board. It doesn't really matter because they all look the same. All right, so when we talk about taking off the sticker, I like to take this sticker off, and here's why. Over here, what the heck is this? Rice, great. Over here, there's going to be heat because this is directly opposite of the touch IC area. And that heat will actually cause that sticker to contract a little bit. And when it does that, so here's the touch ICs. And if we flip over here, that's directly here. And this is the majority of sort of these problem areas that we're talking about. So if you leave the sticker on, then this sticker will contract a little bit if there's too much heat here, and that can sometimes pull this little dude, which is important for a proximity sensor. So I like to take him off, but Mark's going to leave it on. Now, Mark's new thing is what?
What, the no shields?
Yeah, Mark's gone completely rogue, and yeah. Tell us your rationale. So he does... absolutely no shielding whatsoever. I'm going to do... It is too bad that... You know what? Let's switch microscopes for the second one so that okay. We can watch your technique. Because mine right. is different. Because you do yours on the side and I do mine like this.
So my rationale behind the no shields is that it lets you deliver less heat to get the ICs off. So there's less chance of heat transfer through the board. The shielding either prevents your airflow from getting around everything, or in the case of using coins, they act as heat sinks that pull heat out and it takes longer to remove the chips.
So. Interesting. I kind of like that, but you know, I wouldn't steal your technique.
No, definitely not. And don't tell
until
Ben.
After you leave.
Don't tell Ben I stole it from him.
I won't. I won't tell Ben that, and I definitely will not share your proprietarily developed or proprietarily stolen methodology with anyone. It's your secret is safe with me.
All right.
All right.
Well, you don't have that many subscribers. I'm not worried.
That's right. It's not like Lewis's channel. I mean, God, what if he were to... tell about your no shielding. That'd be a whole different bag of cats.
Catastrophic.
Okay. Good thing he doesn't watch my videos. All right, here we go. Nobody watches my videos. Nobody that I know. All right. So I am going to shield. I'm going to stick a quarter down here. I'm going to stick a quarter up here on top of the Wi-Fi chip. And, you know, I'm not using any captain tape or anything else, just those couple of quarters. Now I'm going to go ahead and take off my cumulus. So Mark, the golden question, what temperature do you use? Here's the golden question. How do you answer the question of what temperature do you use for touch IC removal?
Well, the temperature I use is a 6 millimeter tip with airflow at 15 on the little ball gauge, and I use 370 degrees Celsius.
On the
digital thing, and I keep the tip around 1 centimeter from the board.
It's quite detailed when all we wanted to know was the temperature.
Well, that's because temperature is meaningless.
Temperature is meaningless. See, now I already fucked up something slightly, which is this little resistor that I need back.
Well, it's not really in frame, so if you wouldn't have said that, nobody would have ever known.
I would never deceive my subscribers like that. One guy got like royally pissed. It was hilarious on like something where I was doing this like YouTube, you know, some kind of just basic YouTube job a long, long time ago, and it was like the bus came or something, and you know, I did something like this, like kind of absent-mindedly corrected a little like guy like I'm doing right now with that resistor. Uh-huh. See, he just corrected. and then I like kind of split the scene or whatever, went out and came back and it had magically corrected itself. And he was like, "See, you know, you didn't address that." What you're supposed to do, just deceiving people. All right, next. Now here's a big question. I don't know what Mark's doing anymore. Let's talk about how are we going to deal with these pads. I am going to tin them with leaded. What are you going to do, Mark?
I have been tinning with leaded after our lengthy debate on the subject.
Really? Wow! Wow! That's what I like about Mark. He's very evidence-based. So Mark and I had a straight-up, you know, academic, like, grad school journal club fist fight, except for not fist fight part. About the relative benefits of what we're doing right here, which is mixing leaded and lead-free solder on these pads. And we had it out. And I took the research that I read to mean that there wasn't a whole lot of evidence from that particular paper that mixing was an awful, awful crime, like it seems to be portrayed to be.
And I agree.
That's not what you said that night. Like,
well, I think that particular study leaves a lot to be desired.
I would agree with that.
But I think
this
that
is like
the...
way not the same conversation. Like, what is different?
Well, it's just...
I know what it is. It's that the course starts tomorrow. The last time we talked about it, the course ended tomorrow. That's
but
the big difference.
The basic premise that it's not necessarily bad and could possibly be good,
yeah,
is I accept that.
Okay.
But I still think that their like methodologies in testing were flawed.
All right.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Jessica.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, I'm
you're
sorry
here.
To leave.
Yeah, no problem.
Oh, yeah, great. We were just talking about you.
Yeah.
My car was dead as well, along with my phone today, so I apologize.
Wait, well, your phone's dead. What?
My phone, yeah.
What?
Started on my cell phone.
Say hi to YouTube.
Yes, by the way, if you walk over here, you can, you'll find yourself on the
right.
Internet.
Yeah. We can make you a star.
Hey, Fox. Yeah. All right.
You're going to be a star. All right, let me know if you have any questions.
All right, I'm just going to get going here.
All right, sounds good.
By the end of the week, at least 150 people are going to know who she is that didn't know before.
Yeah, it's true. Like, Sunday still answers the phone. Wait, are you Sunday from the toilet phone?
That's so funny.
Oh my God, I had to carry the business phone last week, and it was just, I wanted to shoot myself in the face. Mark, I think you should have to carry the business phone for just like a day.
No, no, I worked in a call center before. Like, I will never, no, work does not involve phones for me ever again.
Why? What was so bad about the call center?
I used to get cussed at by old ladies. By the elderly.
Really? Old ladies saying bad words? No.
Yeah.
Like grandmothers?
Yes.
Grandmas, like Lewis's grandma?
And I didn't feel bad about it at the time, but I do now.
Wait, what? Cussing them back out?
No, I didn't cuss them back out.
Shut up, you old fucking cunt!
Is
that what you said? Did you ever say that?
I intentionally made them mad, but stayed within, within like the acceptable like guidelines and scripts that I was allowed to.
Like what? How does that work? Like just intonation and stuff like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, just, you know, making them feel like that, you know, they probably aren't very good with computers.
And why would you do this?
That was how I coped with the reality of working in a call center doing Microsoft dial-up technical support.
All right, I have a legitimate question about call centers. Now, this is something that I think is true just empirically, which is, oh, by the way, I started swapping my quarters for cold quarters like midway through. That's my new technique here.
Yeah, I swapped mine for no quarters.
All right, here's what I think is true, but I don't know if this is true or not. Is this true? A call center employee cannot hang up on the customer. Is that true?
That is, you're not supposed to, but you can do it. Like it, you.
Is it kind of like getting, like having the manager void your receipt when you're a cashier? It's like, they can do it, but they just don't like to?
Yeah. And, like, if you do it too much, you will get in trouble.
Yeah.
And they can tell, you know, there's no way to do it without your manager knowing that you did it.
Yeah.
But, like, you,
well,
you get a
certain
number of
freebies. Well, what are the reasons where it's okay? Guy's a douchebag. Got another D-bag on line 6. I'm hanging up.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, it depends on the situation there. It's conceivable that there are times where, you know, like, instead of escalating to a higher tier of support, you just kind of...
escalate to your friend Tone?
Yeah.
Let me let you talk to my friend Tone. Boop! Well, one time I was really pissed at AT&T because I had just, when I lived in Baltimore, I had just, you know, re-upped the contract for another 2 years and gotten another little Nokia phone. And then I moved here to Rochester, and I had asked someone, you know, that works for AT&T, will I, you know, get service in the new place? And they, like, look it up on the map, and they say, yeah, it looks like we have coverage up there just fine. And I said, if I don't get service, is there going to be a problem? And they said, no. That was not true. So when I actually got up here, there, to this day, is practically no AT&T coverage. You know that. Mm-hmm. You're on AT&T. How many bars of AT&T are there right here in the shop?
In the shop right here?
Yep.
Is there less than zero? Like, it sucks bars
negative
out of
one,
the phone?
Negative one bars. Correct. Right. So... and by the way, I put way too much heat on my cumulus, but that's just the way it is. So, you know, we got up here and I'm like, well, this coverage sucks. I don't want to have a 2-year contract with you guys. And they said, too bad. You should have read the 10 million pages of fine print, which say, you know, if you don't like your coverage, suck our dick, you know. That's pretty much what it said. So I was furious about that. So what I did is I just kept arguing with them, just out of frustration. And then they kept saying things like, well, is there anything else that we can help you with? You know, is there anything else I can help you with? And I would just keep saying, you know, no, And then I would just sort of restate this whole thing. And they were getting really frustrated. And then it just occurred to me that they're not allowed to end the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
They're required to, like, from her answer, she was waiting for me to go, I guess not, bye, click. But she couldn't do that. So then I just said, when she said, is there anything else? I said, yeah, I wanted to tell you about this recipe. And then I just started reading a magazine to her. And then
started filibustering?
Yes, I did. And then I said, you know what's really interesting? The phone book. This is back when we still had phone books. And so I got the phone book out and I'm like, you know who's got a really cool name? It starts with a B? Blangley. And it just, you know where he lives? You know, and just kept doing that. What are you looking for? Thought Tracy's.
Yeah.
So I did that for as long as, and she's like, ma'am, you're just wasting everyone's time. And I'm like, I know, like the only thing I can do, the only way I can fight back is to, make this more difficult for more people to have bad experience with you guys. And, that will be bad for your business. That's the only thing I can do. All right. So I'm going to test this first one. I really don't feel that great about it. Too much chatting. But we'll see.
Mine's going perfect.
Hopefully. Well, perfect in that you're creating a couple of problems to deal with.
No.
Because this video is going to suck otherwise. If I get a nice problem, then I will have done my job. Let's cross your fingers that proximity doesn't work.
Oh, I'm sure that something's not going to work on yours.
All right, here's one thing I had to learn the hard way. Mark had to tell me this. Right here, when you're plugging in the battery and you've got your dock connector and there's the little antenna guy there, don't leave him disconnected, or else it will create a small short that will make the phone boot loop. I learned that one. All right, so let's see if I have touch, and then we'll check the other stuff. Oh, this is your first board, though, because we're going to switch for the second board. Okay.
Oh, I've got to do it without the Barlow lens.
Oh, the poor workman blames his tools. Yay, I have touch. Hooray. Oh, man, it's that freaking activation. I won't be able to know.
Oh.
Wah, wah, wah. See, there's a problem that I can't test.
You might
test
be able to get
problems
through it. Sometimes they remove iCloud. I always check just to be sure.
All right. Well, in this case, I'm going to have to get a Wi-Fi antenna connected here. Wait, the reason why you don't watch videos is what?
I used to.
You did?
But then, it started being, all of the content of your videos were just, conversations that we'd been having for months. So it's like, I've already heard everything you have to say on this subject.
Oh, man, that count. There's going to be some surprises in there.
Sim required.
He didn't give me a sim.
What's the IME I start with?
Let's find out. 3-5-4
AT&T.
All right, sweet. That's why it's great to be an AT&T. we'll rob my personal sim. All right, here we go. All right, so we got through to the screen. Let's check our cameras. Rear camera, check. Front camera, check. Let's check our proximity sensor. How do you check proximity sensor?
I go into the voice memo app.
Me too. God damn it. I was going to learn something. And do you record a little voice memo like this, and then you play it back on both ear speaker and loudspeaker, and then you use your finger instead of your face to check the...
Yeah, I'm not putting my face against some crazy random person's...
God damn it, all of my voicemails are now on this phone. It just downloaded a
show. Oh, yeah.
No, stop! I have a ton of them.
You need to have SIM cards that are, not active.
Yeah.
That'll just get through the activation.
Yeah. Whoops. Well, so that's another problem. If you use your personal SIM card, then you have loaded your ton of voice messages onto your customer's phone.
Things Jessa learned today.
Things I learned today. Proximity sensors working. God damn it. All right. So
here's the problem.
Ambient light sensor. How do you do that? Do you just do this and then like let it
Yeah, I do it while I'm in settings checking Wi-Fi.
Smart.
Display and brightness. And then turn it off, slide it down. Turn it back on when it's not under the light. Yeah, that works too.
God damn it. There's nothing wrong with that's like never. All right, so nothing wrong with this one. So it's going to be take it back out. Put the future-proof shield on it, which has been huge for us. To date, we have put shields on all phones that we did for a month, and we've gotten zero warranty returns. Yay!
That's a big improvement.
It is a big improvement. It is a big improvement. I think that the community, I don't know what percent warranty is sort of general, but it's, you know, I don't know, 20 or 30%, a lot, you know.
Yeah.
Compared to a standard repair, which is like 1 in 100.
Yeah. I feel like anyone who says it's less than 20% is
full of shit.
Yeah. Either full of shit or their customers just are like, I'm never going back there.
Full of shit or a genius and needs to start a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
I
need to get that screen because this test screen doesn't have all the front camera.
All right. How are you making your future-proof shields?
I have been cutting them out of proximity sensor works.
God damn it! This is the worst video ever.
I know. Like, if I could have just been recording a couple of nights ago. Like,
all right, so that's the video, and then let's do another set of four. God damn it!
Yeah. So my shields, I've been using iPad mini shields. I've been cutting them out of that.
Yeah.
Cut them down the center, and then get like six of them out of one of these shields.
Where are the scissors that live here?
I don't know.
Gene, do you know where scissors are? Shipping. Ah-ha-ha! Thank you very much. Mark, do you actually kind of, a little bit in your heart, like touch IC repair? Yes or no? No? I don't either. I hate it. Fucking hate it. Can't wait for this shit to be over. Oh my god, I hate it.
Yeah. I don't. It's,
you don't?
It's been my own personal hell for the past year.
Yeah. Yeah, I
can. And I'm glad you finally joined me.
Yeah.
do you have an appreciation
for what a pain in the ass it is? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for like, there's been a few times during this past year where I've just been like,
no
what
more.
Am I doing with myself? I need to go and see if there's any call centers in the area.
Maybe AT&T is hiring, because I'd rather hear the alphabet than have to fix another fucking touch IC.
Yeah.
I believe you. I can see that. That's totally legitimate. Totally legitimate, 100%.
And for the longest time, I thought that like I was alone.
You were crazy.
Yeah, like it's just me.
Well, Mike.
Yeah. All right. It's just me. So, but I would like to say that my pre-shields percentage is still pretty good. All right. So I'm doing it like this. Can you? Oh, nobody can see a goddamn thing. This is the worst video ever. Really is. Like, I say that with every video, but this video is actually the worst video ever, I'm pretty sure. I mean, it's not even, like, how can we even post this? Watch Jessa and Mark do touch ICs again. Jessa and Mark come to talk to you about problems with touch ICs, but everything works out fine, so.
Yeah, just.
There you go.
Half hour of Jessa and Mark bullshitting.
This is a touch ICs and what it's actually like to work at a call center. iPad rehab. Oh man, this is the kind of way I feel like it is in the middle of the course week, not the night before it starts. This is gonna be a long week.
I'm pumped. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to do this.
Are you? Have yeah. you learned how to speak Korean?
No, but I'm looking forward to learning some this week.
Tomorrow?
Yeah. Yeah.
Somebody, a student is coming all the way from Korea who doesn't speak English. So make sure you spell his name right so he knows he's in the right place tomorrow. So I'm really interested to see how that's going to turn out.
Is his last name Nguyen?
Huh?
Is his last name Nguyen?
It's probably Lee.
So I believe that that's like Smith.
Yeah.
In I think it's Korea, like South Korea.
You mean Vietnamese?
Oh, is it Vietnamese that's Nguyen?
Yeah, I think so, but I could be wrong. Now I'm totally second guessing myself and look like a fucking idiot. And by
that's okay.
Nguyen,
nobody will ever see this.
You mean
video.
Nguyen, right?
Yeah, no, Nguyen.
Right, of course. Do your touch AC shields look this bad?
I don't know. You're not in frame very well.
God damn it!
The white balance.
God damn it! Oh.
No, that looks no. Mine definitely don't look that bad.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, we'll see, pretty shield boy.
I always assume that there's a good chance that, you know, if it does come back for warranty, my boss is going to see it. So I'm like, I got to make this pretty.
Gotta make it look nice.
Yeah.
All right. That one is ready for reassembly, and then it will declare its problem after I get it all put it back together. Then...
Yep.
Then it will
and then
have
when,
a full show.
When you address that,
yep,
you're going to make touch stop working again.
Yes, and then I'll put two or three more sets of touch IC chips on it, and then I'll realize that I had a little bridge on the PMIC. And then I'll put it in Mark's pile. That is my favorite part of the job.
Yeah.
The monthly Mark's pile. My favorite thing. Okay, so here in this area, since the sticker was gone, we didn't have any trouble. You know what? I think I'm going to leave the sticker on the next one just to show what that can look like. Because, I mean, that's the whole point of this video. Otherwise, it's turned into a ridiculous just podcast of stupidity. My favorite video that we never posted and I think deleted. Is
the six home flex?
No, it's not that one.
It's
which
not
is,
that one.
No, that one. The 5-hour tracer.
Yeah.
No, it's not that. It's the late night iPad Pro.
Oh yeah.
The late night iPad Pro that includes the line. I think I just saw fire. Yep, I did. There's some smoke. What was there? Were some like hilarious lines in that I don't
know. No, that was the video that we talked about later, and we're like, we were just delirious and thought that was hilarious.
But
and
it's
it
actually
wasn't.
Not. There's something about you saying you didn't work in the zoo or something like that. I don't remember what it was.
I don't remember.
I don't remember much about
you want to see my like beautiful, perfect shield install?
I do. Let's switch and I'll just finish up reassembly. Actually, right. Let's make
we'll
a clip
in case
and let's switch so that Mark can show off his shield. His fine ass shield.
That's right.
You know what other video we need to make this week?
What's that?
Us weightlifting. Yeah, you gotta keep up with your weightlifting when you get back home, and then we'll see like how much improvement you have month over month.
Look at that! Look at this beautiful shield soldered on there.
That looks the same as mine.
No. Looks way.
Did you clean your stickery crap? From the bracket.
Yeah.
Before. That's I didn't bother.
Yeah.
I cut the little sticker to be shorter.
It's the little things that all add up.
It does. That special touch.
Wonderful
that little
product.
That little kiss of extra service that you get from Mark of having no sticker residue just kind of gummed up in there.
That's right.
That makes all the difference in how mad you are when you have to send it back to Mark for warranty.
Big no-no in
you know
what
would be really funny
world.
If there was like some like hidden trick or secret, you could be like, this is like 50 minutes into some video that the only people that are going to watch this are really hardcore diehard fans.
Well, that's if we finally get problems with the touch ICs,
it's
going to
be
about
like
50 minutes
like,
in.
Oh, look, here's, and then all it's going to be is, see this guy, the proximity sensor guy? Yeah, you got to like reflow him.
Like we've already lost everyone
well,
who
no.
isn't a
well,
fan.
Well, that's what's really
or...
sad. That's what's really sad. Like whenever you do these videos, and it'll be like average time watched 7 minutes. Like, what? Like, 7 minutes is nothing. Like
yeah.
There's no information has been.
Yeah,
exchanged.
We hadn't even discussed call centers at 7 minutes.
Right. That's right. Okay. Oh my gosh. You know, whatever, you know.
Oh, we've got a no Wi-Fi.
No Wi-Fi!
No Wi-Fi.
Aw, that one kind of sucks, because you're not going to be able to solve it in the time of the video. Tell us your approach. Secretly tell the diehard viewers that are still watching this video how to handle a no Wi-Fi phone.
Well, first I see if the time is correct. Which, is it 7:01 p.m.?
No, it's 10:43.
No, it is not. So I will let the computer update the time on the phone.
And how do you do that?
Hook it up, connect it to iTunes, and usually it'll just update by itself within a few minutes. Go into settings and turn, you know, auto set time on and off. I don't know. I just go in and play with stuff until it works.
That's about what I do. I had to do that the other day. Now, with the grayed out Wi-Fi, I've been noticing that it will just, it's almost like it's more common for grayed out Wi-Fi to be a software issue. Or I don't know what kind of issue, but if you let the phone sit and kind of come back to it, it will figure itself out, and then Wi-Fi will be enabled again,
mm-hmm.
Rather than it being a hardware approach. So
yeah, I've never had to do anything hardware-wise to fix grayed out Wi-Fi.
Now, if you show how you would look for, you know, is it what would be the sign that it is a hardware problem?
The solder balls around the Wi-Fi chip.
Right.
So I'm going to try resetting network settings.
What are you doing?
Resetting network settings. It'll be working.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've done that before. I had one like that last week, and I did, like, I would keep putting it on manual time, you know, like to try to, mm-hmm. like, kind of get it to unhiccup. And then it gave me, you might want to take the SIM in and out, because then it said update carrier settings, and I said okay. You know, and then I just kind of let it think about itself for a while, and then when I came back, it had updated or, you know, figured itself out enough, and everything was fine.
I'll need your SIM.
Okay. Now, all my voice. Maybe I should delete
no.
my 10,000 voicemails.
You can hand me mine. I've got AT&T,
no,
and I don't have voicemails. I refuse to set my voicemail up.
That is smart. My voicemail says no one's ever going to hear this.
You
need to call the business number.
For years now, people have given me shit about not, like, it says, I'm sorry, this customer has not set up their voicemail.
Yeah,
and,
that's pretty good.
And people give me shit about it, and I'm like, well.
Would you rather
you know,
me just
yeah.
never return your call?
Yeah,
like does.
Now you definitely know that I will not get the message, because you can't even leave one. Like,
right.
You know, it would be dishonest of me to set up my voicemail.
Yeah, I need to take mine down. That would be like very.
It's not something that I ever asked for. If there was a way, I've called to see if there's a way that I can just make my phone not have voicemail.
Sounds like
you're AT&T is like, nope.
Nope.
And so, yep, not setting it up.
Okie dokie. All right, can I have my screen back?
No, not yet.
All right, then I will stop trying to steal my number two. Another good idea for a video would be to do a knitting group video.
I'll talk about the knitting group.
Why not? Everybody knows about the knitting group. People that come to the class know about knitting group, and then they're going to want to know how to get into knitting group, which is impossible. It's like Fight Club.
Yeah.
Well, let's rename it.
You don't talk about Fight Club.
Well, that's not.
That's like the first rule. God.
Like it, but it's not called Fight Club.
You would be kicked out of Fight Club like the first day.
It's knitting group. It's like the anti-Fight Club. It's like super nice, you know. But I think it would be kind of like, you know, board repair is not super isolating. It's fun. It is, you know, you can be connected with all sorts of people all over the world and, you know, chat about problems. You got to find a small group of, like, you know, go to like intro to microsoldering Facebook group. Find some other people that are kind of at your level and make a little group and chat the day away with your board repair problems.
Yeah, everybody does that. Like, everybody I know has their own little.
Yeah, has their, like. Well, here's what's funny. When you're in one group, there's like the groups that are the very visible public groups. And then there's like little secret groups and side groups and what have you groups. Like a Practical Board Repair School alumni group is a secret group. And then there's like groups of just a couple of people that talk to each other. And then, you know, somebody in one of those groups will screenshot a piece of a conversation from one of those to some other group. And you're like, wait a minute, you talk with them? Oh, I see. I see. It's like board repair cliques. Like,
yeah.
High school cliques. And they're like, oh, I didn't know. Oh, so basically anything I ever tell you, you're just going to go tell, you know, those three stooges, you know. I see how it is.
All right. This is getting the shelf fix.
Shelf treatment. You know. But
I just
sitting in here, I do almost always data recovery.
I either put on some music or I just quietly contemplate suicide.
Better than loudly contemplating suicide. Hey,
well, everybody else is asleep and I'm not going to be inconsiderate.
About my blue golden tweezers.
I need to get my SIM tray back out of this guy's phone.
Yeah, you need to take care of your SIM tray. That would really suck if you're like,
SIM card.
Cecilia, I have good news and bad news. Is this Jessa? No, this is Mark calling from Jessa's phone. Why are you calling from Jessa's phone? Well, that's the bad news. I left my SIM tray in some dude's phone. What's the good news? I fixed his touch IC with no problems. Oh, I just assumed you were working on Beer and Liquor Day.
Oh, no.
Oh, I just touched one of the trailer park dudes.
Oh, no.
Just one of them, though. I did slide the whole row this week, though. And I was feeling bad about it until Ronnie, like, did something even worse. And then I was like, okay. I don't feel so bad.
I need that X-Acto blade.
Who was it that said trailer park? I think it was James from the last class. I thought that was hilarious. The whole trailer park.
Yeah.
This,
for the benefit of the viewers, this is the trailer park here.
Yeah, the trailer park. And I just You and slide. I just took the second trailer. Second trailer pulled out and went on a camping trip. Over in here, show them what mine looks like. Here, just pass that port over.
Sometimes a twister comes through. And...
yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. Okay, so you just you're taking him out for a ride there.
Yeah, he's just turning around. No, you don't want to. You don't want the tires to get flat.
Well, that's I much prefer that than when you
nudge the whole roll notch.
When the one on the end is touching that one, and then you separate them, and this one pushes over and touches that one.
Well, what I did last, like 2 days ago, was I nudged Mason down, and the whole trailer park went down one whole spot. So Cumulus was gone, so that whole row went bloop, backed it up one spot. And I was just, it was like, I couldn't believe that I had done something so egregious. Just like, it was like, seriously? I'm almost kind of impressed, you know? Like,
yeah, you could not have done that on purpose.
Yeah, you couldn't have done it on purpose. And it was just like, I had no idea. You know, I mean, I am chatting all the time. And, you know, like, I had no idea that I was capable of such... you know, serious damage. You know what we should do is demo how to nudge it back in. That's like exactly what we should do. You want to switch or you want to do it?
I'll do it.
Alright. I mean, I was actually kind of impressed with that, with the whole row, that I nudged them all back in with hot air. Now, do you find that your blue tweezers are too magnetic to do that?
Yes, that's where are the good ones?
You mean these?
No.
Oh, you mean though? I know what you mean.
Yeah, the
you mean those.
The ones that are locked up.
You mean the ones where somebody makes a comment, I hope those aren't the $50 tweezers. And you're like,
all right, here we go.
Oh my God.
What?
Are you kidding me?
What's wrong with them?
I don't know. What is...
a little flux.
What is wrong with
Wait,
the curly
what?
Tweezers?
No. Did you trade me?
No, mine weren't even that bad after TSA got done with them.
Wow, they weren't. I just used these the other day.
To do what? To, like,
to crochet?
Jam them into
a... I made them. Wow, those are really soft. Dag.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah,
didn't...
so yeah, I'll sell you these.
No freaking way.
What are you talking about?
So I'm going to say on this, I would tin those pads a little bit. They're looking a little gray.
Here, these are totally bad. Legit. Oh,
that's the light.
We need that. What? No? I saw a microphone commit suicide. Oh my God, this video is boring.
Beginning hour 4 of our marathon repair.
Well, at least it's a problem.
There we go. Got one side tacked down. That makes
Beautiful.
It easy. Now come in.
Here, try them now.
No way.
No, I fixed them.
No.
Like, you're going to be impressed.
No.
They are so straight.
Let's see.
They are perfect.
Oh my God. I can work with this.
So $50 tweezers are no longer recommended.
Well,
I mean, seriously, that was stored in the case 100% of the time, and I did trace repair the other day. You know, so it was just like yours. Like, you took them out of a plane trip, but it was in the case. You know, I didn't use those for any kind of anything.
All right,
beautiful.
So yeah, there's other
like, I've been super careful
that are stronger.
Yeah, like all of the other alloys.
Yeah, I picked the one.
You
the
picked
only,
the one that
the only
that
one
is
specifically
said
it
aluminum
was non-magnetic.
Foil.
Yeah, the others didn't specify non-magnetic, and since that's the thing I hate about the blue tweezers.
All right, gotcha. All right, give me back my board and don't mix them up.
All right, now I can demo. My chips off with no shielding and with the good flux.
Oh, you need me to pass you the good flux?
No, here. I've got the good flux.
Here's the good flux right here.
I keep the good flux with me at all times. Why is there so much melted plastic on your
on what? That may or may not have dropped into a trash bag earlier this week. Jeff came in here today and he's like, what stinks in here? I thought it would have burned off by now. That is, we really need to get serious with air handling this week because of that. So Mark uses a completely different approach on his positioning. He likes to grab it in a little bit of an easier way. Yep, solder over here. You grab them really fast, like up off the diving board. I like leave them down and make sure they can.
I nudge them.
Do you?
First, yeah.
I didn't see that. Because you didn't say anything about nudging it since you're doing the demo. For
well, it was out of focus anyways because you use this blue mat that swells up as soon as it gets hot.
So, well, there is that.
Sorry, YouTube viewers. That's all.
That's the best. Yeah. Better come to
footage
class.
Of Bigfoot.
Yeah, this is, you know, the only thing going for this channel is no techno music. Other than that, not much there.
Okay. Your microphone.
So I heard
looks
you
like
were
a...
on the front page of Reddit. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I made some funny little comments about some pictures at an art museum.
My favorite one was the lobster. That was very weird. What was the, like, supposed to be?
It was some like scene of these people eating food and I guess the guy in the corner of the picture had brought a lobster and hadn't quite got it to the table yet.
Yeah, that was very weird.
I don't know, Cecilia could probably tell you all about like that picture and what it was a picture of and like what the artist was, intending with it and all of that. But
yep.
I just saw like some jackass that's always bringing his lobster everywhere.
I was like, it's not funny.
Don't throw away my burrito. It's just loose out on a counter.
All right, I won't touch your burrito.
And don't touch my underpants.
I'll try not to.
But were you ever in a high school play?
No.
No?
No. Because, I mean, it would have been weird if I was.
Why?
Because they,
you didn't really go to a high school?
Yeah. Like, I,
like, what are you doing here?
Yeah.
I'm Jesus. Do you go here? No. No, I do not.
I just like structure. I don't like structure. I didn't as a kid. I do more now as an adult, but as a kid, I...
Well, you are like the only adult I know that gets a cake that says, yay, I woke up every day this week all by myself. Gene,
yes.
We gotta get that cake.
Oh, I'm not gonna need it this week.
You're not getting up.
Wait, what? wait, what?
I'll see you at noon tomorrow.
That's not how that's not how this works.
All right. I'm not even talking about what I'm doing here, but I am tinning all these pads with leaded solder. Adding more flux as necessary.
This one is going to suck. And I blame the Barlow lens.
Oh, no. The Barlow lens makes everything awesome.
Everything is awesome. According to Mark. Oh, I forgot to take my sticker off. Like, I legitimately forgot to take it off. Let's see what the bad news is. And that was also way too long. Bam-ba-da-bam!
Oh, wow. You burned the crap out of that sticker.
Ooh, did I get a little slide on my home connector or not really?
I don't know.
Here,
let's
check
it
out.
Here.
Check it out. Check out my proximity dude.
No, everything's fine.
God damn it.
Yeah.
Why don't you just heat it up so it can move around? So normally, if we weren't doing a video and we were actually doing regular work where shit gets fucked up all the time.
Yeah, if I just wanted it to work when I was done.
Right. Then that little area, the Wait, there is a shift on this. No, there's not. God damn it.
No.
Nope.
Your eyes are getting bad, Grandma.
Oh, man.
You pass me those touch ICs?
Sure. Would you like Cumulus or would you prefer Mason?
Both. One of each, please.
All right, here you go. So how much younger are you than me and how much older are you than Lewis?
Well, you could be my mom. but Lewis...
No, wait. You just had a birthday. So how old are you right now?
34.
34?
Yeah.
I really thought it should be like 36. Are you sure?
Nope. 34, 82.
God damn it.
Yeah, sorry. So
82. Lewis is 88.
Lewis and I could be brothers.
Six years apart.
And you would be mom.
No, I'm 10 years. I'm 10 years. Did you say 32 or 34? I forgot.
34.
All right, so that's 8 years. You're 8 years younger than me and 6 years older than Lewis.
Okay.
How do you get to be his brother and I'm the fucking mom? That sounds like BS.
You got started.
I'm the
really
older
early.
Sister. I'm the older sister. I'm not some fucking grandma. Not your mom. I am 8 years older than you. That is the cool older sister that's in high school that can buy you beer and cool stuff. Not the grandma that can't.
It's
that
the
doesn't
nerdy
know what a
older
U-
sister
URL
that's
is.
Like,
no, it's the cool. I
gonna
can
go
drive.
Be some biologist or something.
No solder balls popping out of my Wi-Fi. Everything looks in place. I'm kind of thinking maybe it won't have touch. Let's find out.
I hate your stupid blue mat.
I love my blue mat. In fact, I'm missing the lack of blue mat over here.
It is absolutely awful.
I love it.
I recommend anyone who is a regular viewer of this channel
use it just
do
for
not get a blue mat.
Get
now, the
two
cutting
blue
board,
mats.
The cutting board I like. I got myself the Epicurean cutting board.
Now, why did you pick Epicurean
sheep? Because you told me to.
You realize that I just picked that because that's the one I happen to have.
Yeah, well,
like I went in there and I had made a salad on it one day, and then I said, this could be good for board repair, and then it never made it back into the kitchen.
This was back in the days before
you knew I was bullshit.
I really,
gotcha.
Yeah, before I really knew you, and I just looked up to you a lot, and like I was a YouTube fan.
Before, and then you watched a couple more videos, you're like, oh yeah, I already know all that. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
In fact, I told her that. That's BS.
So I'm not happy with the way Cumulus is sitting.
I wasn't happy with the way mine either, but I am not gonna do that because I'm gonna see if it works anyway.
Well, I think the chances of there being secondary problems are going to increase.
It's getting ready to go way up.
Yeah.
Extra heat, extra problems.
Mo heat, mo problems.
Mo heat, mo problems. That's the shirt that we need to take. Let's talk about funny shirts to wear to CTIA. We need to have like a different shirt for every day.
I want one made that says, we'll give soldering or board repair advice or soldering advice for beer.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah.
Beer.
Well,
margaritas.
No, I want beer. I want somebody to buy me beer. I want many people to buy into it. I don't want to have to pay for beer the whole
time
I'm there.
You won't have to pay for beer.
I don't want you to have to pay for all the beer that I'm going to drink.
Well, CTIA is a lot of fun, exclusively for things like drinking margaritas and hanging out. Like, actually going to the show floor is dumb, annoying, and useless.
No, I'm looking forward to hanging out with Kyle and like Matthew Perez and all the iFixit guys.
Have you met those guys?
Yeah, I met them at ERC last year.
Oh, okay, right. Sweet.
But yeah, I'm looking forward to that, and I already told Kyle we're gonna get him to do some BGA next time we see him.
Oh wow, yeah. Kyle is surprisingly good natural ability because I think from his welding. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. So you know that's the next.
We're not doing BGA at CTIA.
No, we'll do that at ERC. There it is. Found it. Found a mason.
Gene, Vegas, come on. It's like 2 days. It's super fun. I mean, what's the problem? Birthday, come on.
Back to school.
So what? It's not the first day. I mean, the first day is when the moms need to be there. Then the moms, you know, there's like nothing going on. It's the first week of school is just dumb. Everybody knows that. Second week of school, maybe homework or whatever, but come on. What's the big deal? Oh my God, this has touch. I don't know when the last time I did two in a row that had no problems whatsoever. I need my paperwork for the past week. You know, we could look back on this video and actually time the, because the hot air we're using is the same. I mean, we could actually see, test your theory about time, you know, to pull off the chip and put it back on. It'd be kind of cool. You have my paperwork? I need the passcode for this dude. It's that white paper there. All right, put it back on the camera.
Yeah, I'm doing that.
What do you even call this video? Like, if you have absolutely nothing, if you're kind of lonely.
Sticker is untouched.
Huh?
Untouched sticker, not melted.
Oh, let me see. Let's see. Let's take a look.
No melting of the sticker at all. It's always.
Yeah, that looks good.
It's always this area here, or more often this area here that gets
melted. Well, why
don't
you just tell us, since this is the whole point of the video?
Yeah.
What would you have? What would you do if you had no proximity sensor function? Then what?
First, I would come in. I would pick all the underfill off these guys over about halfway up
the
connector.
You mean the overfill?
Yeah, the black
the
crap.
Silicon cover.
Yeah, this crap. I would pick it all away and then reflow this entire area here and this guy. And then, you know, 9 times out of 10, that's gonna fix it.
Yep.
It's right, these guys right in here are proximity sensor,
mm-hmm.
and then I believe these down here are ambient light sensor.
Okay.
And then this is proximity sensor.
Okay. And what about camera problems?
Camera problems are going to be this LDO right here, the overfill tends to expand and kind of cause this guy to lift.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes the one next to it, which is for Mesa, for Touch ID. So you pick that away, lift it off, tin the pads underneath it, tin the pads on the board, and put it back.
Okay. And then home button connector, I think, slides.
Yeah, that's much less often. If home button connector slides at all, then you need to seriously rethink your approach to this, because that's like you're putting way too much heat for all of those joints and like the ground joints to be flowing at the same time for mm-hmm. it to shift. That shouldn't be happening. That's
and what about backlight? So half your screen's dark. Then what does that mean?
Do we have a 6+ board with the thing removed? I've got my known good here. So half-dim backlight is, in my experience, is always right side, and
uh-huh.
it's this driver right here.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got, that's your left side driver, that's your right side driver.
In the 6+.
In the 6+, yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's often underfilled,
mm-hmm.
and those are even more likely to have problems.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not underfilled, a lot of times you can just get away with reflowing it.
Mm-hmm.
But if it is underfilled, you have to lift it and reball it or just place a new one.
Mm-hmm. And what? And then look at the Wi-Fi chip. So Wi-Fi chips sometimes can get a hardware defect. So if you see solder balls squeezed out of that chip.
Yeah, you're going to see them along
that chip
this
area is very
right
sensitive
here.
To heat. And it doesn't like it. So it will squirt out its internal soldered connections when there's heat that causes the solder inside to expand. It has no place to go. You can take that chip off, reball it, put it back on if you have a hardware problem. But really, most of our experience is that Wi-Fi, grayed out Wi-Fi after touch IC is a software issue that kind of gets better with time. You have that phone sitting around, is it better?
It's sitting over there, but I want to test this one first.
You ready? My dude did not give me a passcode, so that's all the testing he gets. So that's kind of lame. I can't actually test.
Always send a passcode. That is.
Always send a passcode. You know, if you don't, then you know we can't test all this stuff.
Yeah, we don't ask for
touch?
It because we want to look at your pictures. We ask for it because
we
want to
see
your
recipes. That you have clipped from Pinterest. All right, this guy needs a shield.
So what do you think? Is this one going to work?
Yeah.
Are we going to do like four touch ICs on camera that have no
issues? You know what? And then the worst thing that could possibly happen would be, oh, this guy seemed pretty good at touch ICs. Let's send him all our touch ICs. No! I'm ready for touch IC disease to be over, honestly.
Yeah, I've been hoping for months now that Apple just recall it.
It's really sad when the people that are cashing checks off of your design flaw say, can't you fix this?
Yeah.
Can't you take some responsibility here?
I've paid a couple of months of mortgage. I'm ready for this to be over.
Right.
Hey, he gave me his code. And it's the right one.
Nice.
Wow.
Right. This one, I have cleaned off the edges.
Cameras are working.
The hell is that?
I tap on it instead of talking.
Lame.
Yeah, I'm one of those people that like doesn't like the sound of my own voice.
Nobody likes the sound of their own voice. Come on.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Do I really sound like that? Oh my god.
And the power was so low, I didn't get to check ALS, but it's gonna be fine.
Because nothing was disrupted and the sticker was not hot. So.
Yeah. And
so
because
there you
so that's go. That's 100% now.
I think that you could 100% of your no shields, no problems.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's a valid thing to conclude. No shielding, no problems. The Mark Schaefer method of touch IC removal. That's what we should call this video. No shield, no problem. In fact, I think I will.
You know, that would work if you had had problems and I hadn't. That's what I was really hoping for, was that you were going to have, like, proximity sensor not working, ALS not working, cameras not working, like, all of it.
Yeah.
On both of them.
Yeah. Sorry to let you down, bro.
Yeah. Okay, so I just wanted to quickly show, I went back a couple hours later to
test. Is it a couple hours later? Damn, it's 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. Wi-Fi is now working, and all this did was sit on the desk all this time. So,
desk solution. What's that called? The old leave it out.
Let her sit. So, success, and we will make another video in the future where something actually breaks.
But we probably won't.
No, we will continue doing these with the idea that we're not going to make a video, and then something will definitely break, and then we can say, okay, now you see.
All right.
All right.
I don't think it's going to happen.
Yeah.